Fascinating Nouns Extra.
So now this is the Graham Parsons thing we talked about earlier. Tell me a little bit about this painting here.
Well, this is Graham Parsons, a country rock singer in the early 70s who was in the Byrds and Flying Burrito Brothers. And this is his marijuana suit made by Nudie, the famous designer of all the country musicians, Porter Wagner on through. And so this particular painting got in the LA Times in the cover of their calendar section when the Times did an article on this. Mm. So this man here emails me and says, I'm Graham Parsons, road manager, best friend, and funeral director. His name is Phil Kaufman. He's known as a road mangler. He is the man, when Graham Parsons died, they had a pact to Graham didn't want to go out like in the Billy Graham Protestant funeral. Mm-hmm. He wanted his body to be taken out to Joshua Tree, set on fire, and go up with the spirits right. in the sky. So they had this pact. So Phil went out to LAX, double-talked the guys who had Graham Parsons' body, hijacked it, took it out to Joshua Tree, had a little ceremony, set it on fire, and burned it up, and that was the end of Graham. And so that was a big, big deal when that happened back in the 70s. And so Phil was arrested and convicted of abuse of a corpse, which was a misdemeanor, so it was not that big of a deal.
Wait, a misdemeanor?
Yeah, it was only a misdemeanor, abuse of a corpse. So, that's not a big of a deal. So that was a legend, and there's a movie called Graham Thrift Parsons with Johnny Knoxville about that whole thing. But Phil also has a great story here. So I go, Phil, I'll do your painting. So he sends me his mugshot in Terminal Island, 1967. He was in prison for marijuana distribution for sale. And in Terminal Island near San Pedro, he met Charles Manson. Mm. So when he got out of jail, he went to stay at the Spahn Ranch with Charlie and the girls. So in his autobiography, he says, I had sex with more serial killers than anybody in the history of man, because he had all the Manson girls. And then after he got out of prison, he was like a chauffeur driving people from LAX to Beverly Hills. One of his fares was Mick Jagger. So he drops off Mick, gets out of the car, starts walking on the long driveway, and Mick goes, hey, where are you going, man? What about the car? And Phil explains that he just got out of jail, doesn't have a job, he's down and out. So Mick gives him $1,500, says, you're working for the Stones now, man. So go to Terminal Island, kid, sell marijuana. You can't do that, it's all legal now. See, you can't have fun anymore. But if you sold marijuana, you get to meet Charles Manson, you get to work for Mick Jagger, you get the Stones.
And you get to burn a body.
And you got to burn up a Charles Parsons corpse. But that's a crazy thing about this museum. I would never know this guy from Adam, except I knew who he was, but all this happened because of the Velveteria.
Remember that.